Patricia answered the call of God.
See this plan to that.
Within a few short years, it was clear that God had given her a heart for the people and an anointed gift for speaking.
Yeah.
Subsequently, she was ordained an evangelist. Sincere then, Patricia has traveled around the world, preaching the gospel, helping to establish churches under the leadership of her pastor. Later, she went back to school, studied the philosophy of social movements, and continued until she completed a doctorate degree. Yeah. Knowledge is power. After that, Dr. Van Pelt traveled around the world, helping parishioners, public officials, and other leaders learn how to organize and mobilize people to overcome challenges associated with unfairness and injustice. That journey led Dr. Patricia Van Pelt into the political arena. Currently, Patricia Van Pelt, PhD. Is an Illinois state senator. Thus far, she has served two terms. Notwithstanding, she remains active in ministry of Jesus Christ and continues to work toward helping people overcome the challenges of living for God in a secular based world. Come on, that is an awesome title. There's a whole lot of lessons that we can get out of just how high up. Education is power. Having a commitment and a love and dedication is power. And not let the obstacle overtake you, but you overtake the obstacle. Come on, let's put our hands together as we welcome this dynamic, phenomenal, awesome woman of God. I salute you.
I was trying to see who that was who was praying like that. She was showing up praying. And I'm going to pray. Father, we thank you. We glorify you for this day that you've given us. We are so honored. So honored to be in your house one more time. We praise you for all these souls that are here, all these lights I see. All of you look like lights, like lamps to me, like lit. My God, we thank you for all of these that have kept their light burning. My God, to hear from you burning, God, that they may be seen by you, that they may be seen by men, that they may give light unto the world. My God, I thank you for it. I pray today that even as I speak these words to them, let them go on good ground, God, and go into their hearts. Help them not to be distracted by anybody or anything. My God, I curse the work of Satan. In the name of Jesus, to the root. And God, today we plunder him. Today we plunder his camp and set men and women free. In your mighty name, in Jesus' name. And let everyone say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap.
Amen.
You may take your seats. And I thank God so much for Pastor Hunter. He is such a man of God and such a heart. The people of God.
Amen.
He's laboring so and building houses, working to build houses and feed the community and work on reducing violence. How many know that's what Jesus would be doing?
Amen.
If Jesus was walking around here in the flesh now, he would be doing the same thing.
Yes, he would.
You know, because it's not right for us just to sit in the church.
Come on,
right?
Come on.
We got a word from the Lord. We've got our salvation. Now we need to go out and serve.
Amen.
That's what we call it, service.
Amen.
Amen. So I thank God for the pastor, man of God, and the first lady, Hunter, who's been such a dynamic prophet. Amen. Happy Happiness for the Lord God and your pastor. I thank God for both of them. The pastor alone and Reverend Spoon and the nurse, who's been a blessing. Amen. We thank God for all the ministries. room. And I want to say special thanks to the members that have come from AFC. And I have here Minister Zionia Ward, Minister Bertha Lesbian, Missionary Bettina Van Pelt, Evangelist Veronica Adams, Evangelist Alicia Pringle, and also we have my firefighter friend, Carmelita Earls. Let's give them a hand clap. I want you two to stand up, Alicia and Veronica. You two stand up. I want you to see them too. Those are two fireball preachers right there. Fireball preachers. I mean, and not just in preach, but I mean showing up anointed. Anointed to tap through some things. You need some stuff torn off, torn through, you call them too. Yeah, bring it. Let's clap our hands for them. That's another glory. You a long time, I'm going to share with you what the Lord gave me for this church.
Amen.
I'm grateful to be able to bring His good news to you. Amen. But before I go into the word, I want to remind everyone about this book that I wrote. This book is for all the Mordecais out there and all of the Naomis out there who want to help single women get married in church.
Yes.
You want to help single women get married in church. That's what Mordecai did. He said, Esther, the king is getting ready. Get him a wife. Let me get you ready.
Hey.
Naomi said, you know what, Ruth, this time you to get married. She said, let me get you prepared for Boaz.
Yeah.
So this book is for all those Mordecais out there and all of those Naomis that are out there. And also, if you are Ruth, you just serving and serving your heart out. Like so many of us do in the church. We serve our hearts out for the work of God. But you know what? The men in the church are few and far between. So this book is about how to use scripture. This book is a scripturally based guide to what works and why in regards to attracting your soulmate, the man of your dreams. Amen. And speaking of the man of your dreams, I just want to thank God for my very fine husband, the man of my dreams, Brother Gene Scott, right here in the front. Amen. When we met, we knew something was going on. It was above our pay grade. I mean, you know what I'm talking about. Because neither one of us was the kind of people that move real fast in any kind of, I'm taking my time. I ain't in the hurry. He's an ex-former Marine, and he's been working for years out of the Crystal Lake area and living out there. And he takes his time, too. Man, we met each other, and it was like two peas in a pod. God told me, you can take your weapons off now. He said, you can lay down your armor because you're home. That's what he told me. He said, you're home. Amen. And I've been blown away. I said, did you tell him I was home? You got me home. I don't know me no more. God was telling him the same thing. But anyway, so let's go into the Word of God. I'm going to share something with you. I know we're supposed to be talking about women of faith today, and I'm going to talk a little bit about that. But I want to give you what God gave me. I want to go to the book of 1 Corinthians, and I'm going to share one verse there, 2 and 12. I don't know if Minister Adams can come up here and help me. Yes, oh, you all stand when the word is preached. The word is read. You haven't actually sit down because I got a lot of scripture. Minister Adams, if you come up here and help me. Can she have a microphone?
Yes.
This one right there.
Okay.
We're in 1 Corinthians, the second chapter, and keep track of time here. 1 Corinthians, the second chapter, and I'm going to read the 12th verse to you while Minister Adams gets ready. It says, Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God. That's the spirit that we receive. And then it goes on to say, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God.
Right.
He said, you know what? He said, I've given you my spirit. And the reason why is because I want you to know what's freely given to you. There's some things that are just freely given to us. And those of us that are women of faith and men of faith and people who walk and align with God, we know certain things. We know that no matter what's going on in our life, all things, what? Work together, right? For the good, right? But those are not the Lord, those that are called according to His purpose. We know that. I don't go through a trial and not know that it's going to work out for my good.
Come on.
I ain't never had a trial like that. I know that. right. Whatever he puts me in the middle of, I know that he's going to be there. He's going to bring me through it. I know that. And certain things you just got to know. And one of the things you need to know is what's freely given to you of God. Spiritual things that are freely given to you. There are people today, go with me to Genesis, minister, the first chapter. And we're going to go right into the first chapter and the first verse. I want you to read for me today. Because this is the life that some people are living right now. Genesis 1:1-2. Read that.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
Okay, now the second verse is what I'm looking for. Read.
The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep.
Okay, it says, and the earth was without form and it was void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. There's too many people in church.